Don't forget to subscribe and turn the notifications. We upload daily, and check the source of this video to view all the images and videos if there was any. A famous village store in remote Gothland could be set to cause national uproar over its decision to sell golliwog merchandise. Mugs, keyrings and dolls featuring the controversial dolls have gone on sale in the village store and gift center, once featured on hit TV show Heartbeat. One visitor to the village, which is also famous for filming Harry Potter scenes, was stunned to see the dolls, seen as symbols of racism, in the shop window. She said the golliwog items were outdated, and in 2018 were blatantly racist. Helen Foster, 49, from Whitby, East Yorkshire said, "For me personally, I wouldn't buy or sell those dolls. They have negative connotations of racism and in this day and age are blatantly seen as being racist. Gothland is like the land that time forgot, but that is no excuse because they are hideous. I noticed them in the shop window a few years back but didn't know they still sold them. I mean, like I said, Gothland is like the place that time forgot, but it's 2018 now and they are seen as racist. I guess not a lot of young people, or a small ethnic minority groups, come here, but I can imagine it being a shock to most." Jolly golly, gifts for sale in Gothland have upset some customers who say it is racist to stock the items. Racist toys are clearly visible in the shop window in Gothland. Customers have been divided over the sale. Claire Fenby Potter and Darren Fenby Potter, 47, happily bought the dolls which they collected in the youth. However, the shop allegedly defended their stock based on the rebranding of the dolls. The golliwog products on sale included hundreds of key rings, fridge magnets, bottle openers, cuddly toys, tin signs, pens, teapots and mugs. But after a staff member was asked why they still sold the blackface dolls, they remarkably replied, "They're called Jolly Gollies now, so it's okay." Mum of two, Mrs. Foster, added, "By changing the name, the people who make the dolls know they were in the wrong." The hit Sunday evening soap Heartbeat brings thousands of visitors to the North Yorkshire village every year. Its main gift shop sells Heartbeat-themed merchandise as well as hundreds of golliwog memorabilia. The doll, which quickly became a negative and demeaning icon in the late 90s, was even lauded as being fine by a family who even purchased one of them. The village store and gift center left customers shocked at the sight of the hideous blackface doll coasters. A steel sign and mugs were among the merchandise on sale in North Yorkshire. The Jolly Golly dolls were rebranded after being long associated with racism over their dress and their hair. "They're harmless. I don't see anything wrong with it," said father of six, Darren Fenby Potter, 47, from Hull, East Yorks. He purchased a £14.99 large doll and gave it to his youngest son during a family day out to the quaint village. He said, "My wife Claire used to collect them as a child on the jam pots. Everyone did. We grew up with them around the breakfast table. I'm not shocked to see them here." However, just last week, Show Racism the Red Card slammed a RSPCA-affiliated charity shop for selling the golliwog dolls in the window. The organization says the dolls' large lips, frizzy black hair and traditional minstrel attire are the product of a racist sentiment. A Show Racism the Red Card spokesman said, "The dolls have unfortunately been used as a racist caricature of black people since then." The charity's spokesman added, "The sale of these dolls perpetuate racism as they hark back to a time when the mockery and stereotyping of black people was considered a social norm." Figurines, pens and other golliwog branded items were on sale in the Yorkshire shop. Fridge magnets are also on sale, advertising the dolls which were pulled from stores in 2007, including Harrods pens and other items which are attractive to a younger generation, also went on sale in the shop which features on Heartbeat. "We urge the public to refrain from buying such overtly racist items and we hope the shop selling the dolls would consider taking them out of the store as one cannot profit on the oppression of an entire community. In a multicultural and ethnically diverse Britain, such items no longer have a place. Some rare versions of the dolls can sell for up to £300 from online vendors and were created by English cartoonist Florence Upton in 1895. Robertson's Jam picked up on the version of the golly to make them their mascot in 1910 after seeing children playing with the golliwog dolls. The wog part of the name was initially used as a slang racist term during the Second World War to describe black or mixed race fighters. As the 1980s rolled in, the dolls and golliwog were seen as a derogatory term for black people. History of the golliwog doll, how the outdated children's toy became a symbol of bitter controversy. Marmalade firm Robertson's removed its iconic golliwog logo, shown, from its preserve jars in 2002 following complaints from campaigners. The issue of whether the dolls are racist or not often sparks fierce debate. The golliwog was created by Florence Kate Upton in 1895 in her book The Adventures of Two Dutch Dolls and a Golliwog, where it was described as a horrid sight, the blackest gnome. After the author created the golliwog, it became a favorite for collectors and was popular in the UK as the mascot of Robertson's Jam. But by the 1980s, it was increasingly seen as an offensive racist caricature of black people. Some people hark back to fond childhood memories of the dolls, whereas others argue golliwogs are a racist icon of a bygone age. Marmalade firm Robertson's removed its iconic golliwog logo from its preserve jars in 2002 following complaints from campaigners. In a YouGov poll last year, 53% of respondents said they thought selling or displaying golliwogs was acceptable, compared to 27% who did not. Asked if it was racist to sell or display a golliwog doll, 63% of respondents said it was not, while 17% did. Robertson's Jam was forced to cut ties with the mascot in 2001 following an uprising of the connotations the golliwog had on communities across Britain and globally. Toy giant Hamleys also stopped selling golliwog merchandise in 2007. The dolls recently changed branding from golliwogs to jolly gollies. Tory MP for the area Robert Goodwill refused two opportunities to reply to questions about the golliwogs being sold in the iconic 60s town. A pair of husband and wife prospective MPs Bill and Star Etheridge were even booted out of the Tory party after posing with the dolls on Facebook in 2011. The company Embrace, who manufacture the dolls, and Elgate, who own the copyright for the products, have both been contacted for comment. The Village Shop and Tea Rooms has also been contacted for further comment.